Dear friends, in the first video, I gave introduction to how the code is functioning, and it might give an impression that the insolvency and bankruptcy code as a legislation has not performed well. There are no two opinions. But you would like to say that the legislation is bad? No, not at all. It is an excellent piece of legislation. It is an excellent piece of legislation. And had this legislation not been there, other legislations like Surface and all, which are very, very ineffective, time-consuming, litigation-driven, you would not have got seen to light the DHFL scam, ILFS scam, and all the big corporates who have taken thousands of crores of money. So please be clear, that's what I've been telling. I've been, many times I'm repeating. It is only to drive home. The point is that it is a very good legislation, fully supported by the Prime Minister and the Supreme Court. What more you want? And very well handled by the adjudicating authorities, in spite of not having proper infrastructure. But at the end of the day, we have not achieved the results, not at all achieved. It's a complete failure. It is only because of the main regulator, IBBI, and MCA. MCA, I'm not here to find faults with any person. You may be also thinking, why we are naming the chairman of the IBBI and also MCA secretary, Mr. Injeti Srinivas. If anyone goes through the media over the last 3 years, these were the gentlemen who are always, always on a weekly basis trying to claim credits. And I have been bringing these loopholes into the system. I have been discussing with many of the top officials who are all very responsive and brilliant. But what I understood, my impression is this is a one-man organization, though it is skeleton-driven and all that, everything is there. It is like a one-man show. It's like our Prime Minister who is running the nation. IBBA is run by Honorable I have no personal thing, I never met him. I have no grievance either. But grievance is one. This is the interest of nation. Today if you see, the nation has no money to pay the Boxing Federation. There's no money to test kids. No facilities. Who are downtrodden people, migrant labor, not having food. In this background, when we have lost 6,50,000 crores of rupees, naturally it is a great cause for concern and somebody must take accountability. So, it is a great legislation. I can tell you it is a great legislation and it can bring results like anything. I am going to prove it. It is only because of, we can say, inexperience of IBBI, or over-centralization of the way in which IBBI is administered. In one word, we will see the case studies which I take. IBBI is only interested in attacking the arbitrage. Resolution professionals are branded like delinquent persons. And they are making regulations or notifications on how to conduct the business. You see the disciplinary cases they are taking, which will not stay in the High Court. But then the membership is tarnished. And in fact, everybody started thinking, RPs are making money. So that is, we will see as we go on. And so we are going to take plus and minus. And therefore, the point I drive home is, the legislation is very good. It is able to bring out the snakes inside. And it is capable of solving this, really capable of solving this problem. But then at the end of the 3 years, it has failed. And let me move further. I have given you examples also that there is a financial discipline has come into the business. I myself have seen in certain cases which I will explain to you. At one point in time, the promoter was already siphoned off all the money, was afraid of this legislation, and he thought of repaying all the money. But later on, having seen the way in which legislation can be taken, everybody started utilizing the code. The everybody means the delinquent promoters in connivance with the banking chair bankers. They tried to get out of this and they were very successful. In fact, when the IBBI has to strategize their functioning, because they were given full support by everybody, every ecosystem, but they did not understand what are the ground realities. And only thing they were going on and on, notifications, regulations, information. If you ask them now, I will ask simple question. Every 10 days to 15 days, we will all get notifications asking within 2 days you fill up, failing which you will be removed as per the 196 something. Now my question is, till now they have not published point number one. 650,000 rupees lost. You have any data? Have you done any research? Is there any white paper? No. Whether it is correct or not, also they have not denied and disputed. Point number one. Next is, you say the object of the IBC is resolution. And why only 3% of the cases were resolved? 97% have gone to liquidation. Is there any thing done? Research paper? No. So when you don't know that itself, this is the cause. And the IBBI, if you read in the page 2, Honorable Dr. Sahu has mentioned that when this legislation was about to be introduced, lot of people have, he says, naysayers. That is, many people doubted the performance. There is no ecosystem developed. Their resolution professionals are not trained. This is what he says. I'm not saying anything. And what is that? The ecosystem is not developed. There is no secondary market for your sale of the products, that is the companies. There is no good management team developed. And this calls for most difficult job. This is what he says. Insolvency professional capabilities are demanding capabilities. Now what did he say? Is he talked anything about this? Whether they, after 3 years, what has been the efforts made with regard to development of the ecosystem? Do you have a secondary market is there developed for the products, the companies? And what did IBBA do? Naturally, nothing has been done last. So when there is no market where you can sell, point one. Point number two, the resolution professionals are most difficult, technically competent persons required. So what did you do? You had one for multiple choice exam. Thereafter, after 6 months only, they started one training for some time. That's all of them are treated equally. And the remuneration is fixed by the CEOs. And a banker can remove you just like that. You say you should be very independent. So you should run it as a going concern. That is the object. Then nobody will fund you. You take interim finance. Well, who will give interim finance? When the banks which have taken mortgage the assets, they themselves are not funding. They are not willing. So when the Supreme Court was testing the constitutional validity and many important cases, the IBBI did not include. They could have supported the Honorable Supreme Court. They have not done research. Private lenders, what is their performance? How many companies which are they have recovered and resolved? Private lenders having a dominant 66% share. And compared to that, all the companies which have gone for liquidation, is it public sector banks? What's really the problem? So we are going to see. I like case studies. If you see, it is treated as nothing but a pure. And you say you are independent. How will you be independent? The day you talk, they will remove you without giving any reasons. You bring this to the notice of the IBBI in several cases of mine, and they did not react. And so many cases, and when you go to NCLAT, they will say, yes, COC can remove. And when you are able to remove, what is the independence? When a Supreme Court judge can be removed by voting, then where is the independence for Supreme Court? Independence is a concept that yesterday also we are reading, RP should be independent. Since he is not independent, he is found guilty. So, RPs are actually, the maximum effort is put on RPs, and they are scared a lot now. And there is no way you recognize, there is no welfare schemes. And on top of it, there are two people who are regulating you. One is Insolvency Professional Agency. Another is this dictatorial, autocratic driven IBB. Why do you need? There are only 2,000, 3,000 IPs are there. For them you need? Actually, we need to change, which I am discussing, that this is like ICM, ICWA, ACS. All these people are member-driven organizations. The members elect the council members who work for the members of government and of these things. Then you can represent efficiently. As of now, the entire thing is gone. So, my point, you all should understand, it is a situation where it is a good legislation spoiled by none other than the IBBI, is my thing. And I am again telling you, this is my opinion. I am not trying to castigate or anything. I have complete data. And you also, as a listener, viewers, can understand. First and foremost, you have completely, after 3 years, you are, till 3 years, if you see the reports of the interviews of the chairman, chairperson, Honorable Dr. Sahu, and also Injati Srinivas recently is giving a lot of interviews about the success. They are saying ease of doing business has come down, and this, everybody is afraid. They themselves publicly said 2 lakh crores have been recovered without even filing the cases. They don't have data. For nothing they have data, though they are collecting the data. So we want them to correct it. Accountability to be fixed, and there can be rehauling of this, overhaul of this army by needs of need of the hour, is my point. So, first of all, they, we have shown that the losses are being reported in the media. Only 3 years you are saying it's done very well. Now it's fallen. And only after I started raising, they are asking some successful RPs to say how you have performed successfully. See, nobody can talk in the open because it is subject to confidentiality. But there should be an opinion collected from these things. And then now they are only fine. Every time you say disciplinary committee report, RP's face is put, name is put, tarnished, and these people say business issues, not done like this, 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 and all. They will not stand before the High Court scrutiny. Anyway, that is apart. So, I am very clear. The IBC legislation is a very, very good legislation. Most effective legislation. And because of this legislation, in the coming days, there will be a very good discipline among the all the stakeholders, particularly delinquent promoters, who were earlier looking bank loan as income. Now they know where they are placed. But it is spoiled by a regulator. That is the first point. You will understand. This is the purpose of my discussion. Now the role of RP, I have taken it. What I was doing is, generally if I speak, you will think it is statements. Now I will give a case study and then make you realize and also develop more points. If you have done, for example, if you do a research, most of the private lenders have made best use of this legislation and recovered the money. And if there is a teamwork between the lenders and the resolution professional, functioning independently. Independently means I am not a boss. I don't have 1 rupee with me. Bankers have to fund. You are saying going concern. But then who will fund? You take interim, who will give? I'll give you case studies. How an RP is being treated in the present context. Whether RPs are really getting jobs, 2,800 RPs are there. In that, how many have experience? So, I have made a lot of suggestions in the lectures that I have taken up for this session. So, friends, now that we say, at least I am saying that the performance of IBBA should have focused on certain vital aspects is missing. First step is, whenever any legislation is introduced, it is based on foreign laws, how far they will be applicable to India, one has to decide. So you have to amend, adjust it to the India. And you can say, this is the most likely thing that will happen. What is the most likely thing that will happen? Past experience is before us. So normally a promoter, when he is taking more loans, a small promoter, small buyer, lender, that is, you are taking money for housing and other things, bankers will be terrific against you. And I don't think there can be losses, retail advances they are coming. But only with regard to business loans, the bankers, the entire problem arises only because in that advances, which are business loans. And you can see, the businessman, the promoter starts with 1 lakh rupees loan. Slowly gains the confidence of the bank. Then he gets into the system and attracts the chairman of the bank and other top decision-making authorities. And then he'll start taking money. This is the past practice. So, there is definitely a nexus between the top bankers and the promoter. So, it's like more family. I was told one person who was a I was the liquidator. He was telling when he goes and meets the chairman. The chairman says, I will not talk to you anything about business. Let us have lunch together. And that fellow has really never paid the money back. They used to take loans and then pay an interest out of it. So, it is, nobody can dispute that fact. So, IBBA must have addressed that. How to look at it. Another problem is, whenever the person wants money, the shrewd people, what they do is, they will also parallelly start a business and this will be, business will be siphoned off there. That business will be doing extremely well and in no way that business can be attacked by the bankers, lenders, whatever you think, they have loyalists, venomists or whatever you call. This is there. The third part is the delinquent promoter. Promoters you can be segregating into three different types in a given situation. The first situation could be that a fellow is doing well and then he got into some trouble. So you can try to get him out of the business troubles. Second man wantonly siphoned off all the monies and then indulged in all these things and got into big losses. And he is safe, but then bank is not safe. The duration taken is so long that nothing is there left in the company. And they are like a dead body is kept on. The loans are further given in the form of corporate debt restructuring and all. The company is dead. So, actually bankers themselves are not competent lenders, if you see. They are lenders. And not entrepreneur lending, they are not able to spot. See, suppose when the business for a turnover of, let us say, 100 crores, they may need a capital of, say, 30 crores. But they will give 200 crores. So the extra money is idle capital. Secondly, when it's going on expanding, you are pledging the land, wasting assets, non-core assets you are lending. A lot of issues with regard to the lending mistakes. That is the basic reason. So, where is the law which tries to look at it? And the bankers, they are called lenders, are given full freedom and power, no accountability. The entire code is like this. Now,
Now, if you go through the law, the promoter and banker's nexus has not been addressed. He lost all the money. And even you do forensic audit, where promoter siphoning off is one side, which you will be able to fix it. Willful defaulter, the litigation. The law is also just some law, 43, section 45, 49, 66. But they are not implementable law. The next point, if you come across, the person who is running the resolution profession, independent, he should run like a going concern. So I am now going to talk about concept of going concern, which is considered by Supreme Court, NCLAT and the court as the most vital for running the CIRP process. Because you want to, bankers, lenders have given, let us say, 500 crores. And the company, if it is kept running, that is, how will you keep running it? You will estimate what will be the minimum fixed cost. And then, in order to recover that fixed cost, what should be the contribution? What is your product mix? What is the working capital required to run it? And that is the role, that is what is being envisaged. When the business is running well, then the people will come to buy. Now you need working capital. Bankers will not. I'll show you all the experiences. Bankers are not willing to fund either CIRP also. And you know, the commercial wisdom of the COC is not justiciable, is the Supreme Court judgment. But actually, who is the person coming in the COC? I've already explained. These recovery officials, they are very tough fellows. They would like to attack you, abuse you, insult you. They are the people. So you should have got advances who are experts to come there. They are not coming. And you see, the mechanism in which COC is operating is totally different. There is no research done by IBBI. So, when an organization, when the reports are saying that going concern is the right way, then what are the legislation to help the RP to run it as a going concern? They are only hurdles which we are going to see. So therefore, first mistake would have been, they identified the problem, that is the courts have identified that keep this as a, the objective is resolution so that workers and all are taken care. To achieve that resolution, if the background is you should be kept as a going concern. But where are the laws, legislation effectively to run? Nothing. Neither the RP is well versed to run the business, nor the RP is allowed to run the business, both by IBBA raising questions as well as COC not allowing him to do anything independently. And you have never given any protection for RPs. So, but then you are going on attacking is what you can see when the law is there. So, sooner than later, the delinquent promoters, they came into bankers, no, we have lended wrongly, so let us not get into trouble. Only RBI is going to investigate. RBI, they won't take any action unless you are rubbing them wrongly. But that also should have been brought into the ambit. And then IBC should have taken up NCLT and RP. That will give more power to RP. The second is to fix the promoters by way of delinquency and then process that is fraudulent transaction. It's not conducive. And RP is the key, but then without keys, that is what has happened. That is the reason for entire loss. The loss arose not because of anything, because of the system. The IBBI top people would have lost the ground realities, is my thing, if I explain all the case studies which you are going to see. I have taken only few and to prove my point. And that means there is a great scope, there is a great future ahead, you can see, because of IBC, provided the following restructuring is done in the law.